At first, you don't succeed. 1 minute and 25 seconds of play remaining. Permian leads it 37-7. They were arguing before the game whether the line should be 6 or 12. Nobody thought it should be 30. It's going to be Paul Burnett to kick off. That's Antoine, and he's good to the 24, and that's all. Stopped by Ty Fowler. One minute and 20 seconds to play, and the state champion mojo is working. They're not doing too much subbing. They're going to run a few in here. It is mainly a senior team. It'll be a rebuilding year next year. First down, 10 from the 24, and it doesn't matter much. We've got a new quarterback in for Sterling, who gets out to the 31, Randolph Craig. And I guess they wanted to let him say he'd been in a state championship game. Moves it to the 30. Dallas taking their lumps in the first half. 37-7. Permian over Sterling, and the clock ticking away with a minute and 14 left. Craig rolling right. Craig struck down hard by Randy Hamlin. Hamlin, by the way, is an honor student. The brainiest of the Mojo bunch. Cost him about a yard, 29-yard line. Third down, about four. The Mojo funeral count, 40 seconds. Craig, back to throw and trapped. Sacked at the 25. James Scott and McCallum in on the tackle.
Again, a reminder for all spectators to stay off the field following the game.
4-3-2. The Mojo wins it all.
Well, the warning of spectators to stay off the field does not always work.
High emotional factor present here.
Absolutely. The Permian Panthers, state champions of Texas high school football, Class 4A for the year 1972. The final score, the Permian Panthers 37, the Baytown Sterling Rangers 7, on a beautiful Saturday afternoon is the way it happened in Austin, Texas. The offensive power of the Permian Panthers never doubted for a moment. They did a beautiful job this afternoon. And, of course, have now gathered with the Baytown Rangers for the traditional post-game prayer. And we'll be back in just a moment with a wrap-up of today's football game. From the Panther partisans here at Austin's Memorial Stadium on the campus of the University of Texas, as the Panthers have brought it all home back to the West Texas town of Odessa. 37-7, our final score, Permian winning. And I guess if accolades are to be given out to a team this strong, as the Permian Panthers have proven themselves to be, I would sum it up in kind of the way I think most of the scouts from the colleges have summed it up. They said the Panthers have one of the finest offensive forward walls you'll ever see in high school football. Their defense is sound. It's held together all season long. They've averaged giving up less than 7 points a game. And the offensive versatility of the Permian Panthers of 1972 is indeed something to behold. Our chief engineer today has been George Wright, the cameraman Tim Gray and Johnny Verdon. Our director has been John Foster. We'd like to say thank you to a host of people, not the least of which are the Austin folks who have made us feel so good, but to our sponsors of today's game, the House of Carpets, Midland and Odessa, to DNC Trailer Sales of Big Spring, to Westex Equipment Company, and an especial thanks to Don Draper, to the B.F. Goodrich Service Stores in Midland and Odessa, and to the American Bank. These fine firms have made it possible for you to view the 1972 state championship football game between the Permian Panthers of Odessa, the Sterling Rangers of Baytown. Speaking for Charlie Boland, this is Frank Childs reminding you our final score, the state champion Permian Panthers 37, the Sterling Rangers 7. Good afternoon from Austin, Texas.